turning back. No turning
Well, good morning. I'd like to welcome you to Mariners this morning, whether you're here in person, and it's wonderful to see so many bright and cheery faces, or if you're joining us online, we're so glad that you're with us too. I'd like to introduce you to the team up here on the platform who's going to be leading you in the musical portion of the service. Kaylee down on the end, Gary right here. I am Mary Beth, Paul, Mike, Noah back here on the drums, and Catherine's doing keyboard for us. We're so happy to be here. Thank you so much. Now, you might be noticing something very different on stage this morning. We're missing our lovely leader, Crystal, but we actually aren't. She's in the back today running the tech with Jim, Carol, Nikki, and Drake, and we are really grateful for that part of the service. That's probably actually the hardest part, much harder than what we get to do up here. Now, we're going to start the singing, and if you're able, we'd love for you to stand and join us, and if not, just please stay seated and raise your voices. Okay.
Your grace. Hey. Great is your faithfulness, O God. Wrestle with a sinner's heart. Lead us by still waters and to mercy, and nothing can keep us apart. So remember your people, remember your children, remember your promise, oh God. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough for me. Great is your love and justice, God. You use the weak to lead the strong. Lead us in the song of your salvation. And all your people sing along. So remember your people, remember your children, remember your promise, oh God. Your grace is enough, your grace is enough. Your grace is enough for me. Yes, your grace is enough. Your grace is enough. Your grace is enough for me. So remember your people. Your grace is enough for me. And God, I see your grace is enough. Oh, I'm covered in your love. Your grace is enough for me.
Next song was written by a couple of guys that got together, Keith Getty and Stuart Towson. They got together and wanted to write a hymn. I don't know that I consider this a hymn. It's called In Christ Alone. And believe it or not, they wrote it in 2001, and it's still in the top 25 of hymns to this day. So would you please join us in singing In Christ Alone?
No one can lay any foundation other than the one already laid, which is Jesus Christ. He is our chief cornerstone.
My destiny, no power.
just a habit we get into with school, isn't it? Tell me when to go. Good morning, Mariners. Good morning. And good morning to those of you who are online. My name is Rebecca Collison, and I am a sinner saved by the grace of an amazing God. And it's my privilege to be pastor here at Mariners Bethel and to welcome you into this time of worship this Sunday morning. And it's a very special Sunday morning, because this Sunday morning we are focusing on the young people in our church, our youth. And we have a youth, a member of the youth group who will be giving the message this morning, but that's in a little bit. And we have a few of our young people being baptized this morning, and you are all a part of that. And how great is that? Thanks be to God. So as we move into the service this morning, just a few things to let you know. If you're new here, we definitely would like, and even if you've been coming for a while but you've not gotten connected, we'd love to get connected with you. So if you're online joining us, there is a connect code and there is that link that we can find out who you are, so you can find out who we are and what we're all about. And also, if you are on site and if it's your first time visiting, we would love to get to know you more. So please stop by the welcome desk on your way out. There's a little something for you there as well. We have opportunities not only to give, there are offering boxes in the back of the worship spaces and out in the narthex, as well as our app that you can go online. And if you're one of those kind of, I do all my bills online anymore, at least most of them, so that's one way that folks like to give. But also, there is a QR code if that's a way that works for you. And we just invite you to give to God because of what God is going to do with that. And God has done amazing things already, and we know he's got more things planned. But the most important thing is we want you to connect with God. We want you to connect through prayer. And prayer is very important at this church. We want to give you the opportunity, if you're online, and if there's some way we can pray for you, because we know everybody brings stuff with them. We carry stuff around with us all the time. And God says, give it to me. You're not meant to carry that burden. I can do it. I can handle that. Bring it to me and trust me. So that's what we do when we pray. And there are cards in the pew backs. If you have a prayer request, you can fill that out. Drop it in one of those offering bins I talked about. Or if you'd like somebody to pray with you, maybe there's something really that is going on that you'd like somebody to pray with you. At any time, you're welcome to go to our prayer room or after the baptisms, and you'll see why in a minute. You can come to the rail. There is that opportunity, or just in your seat, talk, have a little talk with Jesus, and makes it right. It's how the old song used to go. Just a few announcements we want to make sure that you're aware of. Tonight is a healing prayer service at 6:30. It's going to be a little bit different. You don't want to miss it. And just to let you know about that, you're welcome to come as you are. You can participate as much or as little as you want. It's entirely up to you, but you are welcome to come to that. Also, please check out online and all the other different things that are going on, missions that are going on. Just a heads up, if you have a graduate, Sunday, June 4th is our graduate Sunday. That's in 2 weeks. And one of our graduates, Kaylee, will be giving the message that morning. So you won't want to miss that either, because we want to recognize all our graduates. So please let the office know as soon as possible if you have a graduate that we want to make sure that we recognize, especially if they're going to be here. We need to know that we're kind of like at the end of knowing that right now. Just a few more things. Just keep an eye on all the announcements and such. But at this time, I want to invite a very hard, we've given her perks last week with the amazing yard sale, and then the yard sale 2.0 that kept going this Saturday, because you were just so generous with all the things that you gave to help raise funds for CRASH, our youth group, that we just had to have another Saturday to keep trying to sell all that. So, because it filled up the gym and the Hope Center and the garage and everything. So, I'm going to invite Tiffany over. And since she wasn't here for a little bit of that, give her a thanks again, because she's going to need some sleep when this is all over. She is our Director of Family and Youth Ministries, and we are so blessed to have her. So,
thank you. Good morning, Mariners. So, I'm going to kind of piggyback off what Pastor Becky was saying and just give you a little update. Again, I do genuinely appreciate all of the time and the support and the love and the giving that you all have done over the last, I would say, about a month now we've been collecting for the yard sale that we did not anticipate going into week two round of, but we did. We're still working on final numbers, but with your help, we raised about $7,000 for our youth program. Woo! So thank you guys for that. And thank you to all the youth, because there were quite a few who were there for many, many hours and worked very hard. Yeah, I'm waving at you. Yes. Hello, thank you. So I want to thank all the youth, too, because you all worked just as hard as I did on this. So at this time, would you all bow your heads and pray with me? Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for bringing us here together, whether we are here online or in person. Lord, we just thank you for all of the blessings that you continually provide for us, even when we don't realize it in the moment. Lord, I pray that you would just fill this place this morning. Today is a special day. Today we will welcome two members into your kingdom, along with many others. And I just pray that everyone who is either being baptized or is part of the baptism in their family and the congregation, just realize how important and how precious this moment is. And Lord, we just pray that you would continue to work in their lives and through them so they can bless others for you. And Lord, we pray all these things in your precious name. Amen.
Amen. All right, now I have a little logistical challenge here, so just work with me on this. We have two being baptized this morning, and we are very blessed by that. But I do want to ask if we have any children that are going to be here for Miss Michelle's message. Okay, because I'm going to ask them to meet Miss Michelle up here first, and if you all wouldn't mind having a seat on the steps, so you have the front view of everything that's going on, because this will be important to you. Because one of the members of your class is going to be baptized this morning as well. Because it's going to get crowded up here really quick. So that's why I need you to sit up here for front view of everything that's going on. Okay, do we have them all that's coming up? Okay, we good? Everybody's adjusted? Yeah. Okay, we're good then. Oh, there's one more. Well, you got to be up front, though, so you got to sit on that first step. There you go. This is a little bigger deal there. Okay, so what I would like to do at this time, since Talon's already up here, is to invite his those who will be standing with him over to this side, if you would come stand over here. And our other is Isabella Grace, who we know as Bella. And we would like to ask Bella and her entourage, including her youth, to come all up here on this side. All the youth, come on. On this, right here. Because we're going to get him wet. That's okay. So I want all the youth to stand on this left side, and all Talon's group stand on the right side. Because I have different questions to ask each side. So I'm not challenged on this. There's just different ways I ask you questions. And it's really easy answers, okay? Okay, we good? Yeah. All right, so, brothers and sisters in Christ, through the sacrament of baptism, we are initiated into Christ's holy church. We are incorporated into God's mighty acts of salvation and given new birth through the water and the Spirit. And this is all God's gift given to us without price. Where's my lay leaders? I need one. Carrie says, I'll do it. Grab a mic, Carrie. Grab a mic, Carrie. Is there a mic down there? They're so shy. We're going to kind of do this in two parts. Okay.
I present Talon Matthew Sprinkle for baptism.
All right, Talon, come on up here. I need you to stand right in front of that over there, okay? All right. And to your parents and your family, I ask this question. Beloved, do you, in presenting this child for holy baptism, confess your faith in Jesus Christ, accept your duty and privilege to live before this child a life that becomes the gospel, and to raise him up in Christian faith, keeping him under the ministry and guidance of the church until he, by the power of God, can accept for himself the gift of salvation and be confirmed as a full member of Christ's church? If so, say, I do. Okay. Now you have the second one to do.
I also present Isabella Grace for baptism.
Okay. Isabella. On behalf of the whole church, I ask you, do you renounce the spiritual forces of wickedness, reject all evil powers of the world, and repent of your sin, accepting the freedom and power that God gives you to resist evil and injustice and oppression in whatever forms they may present themselves? And if you do, say, I do.
I do.
Do you confess Jesus Christ as your Savior, put your whole trust in his grace, and promise to serve him as your Lord in union with the church that Christ has opened to people of all nations and races and ages? And according to the grace given to you, will you remain a faithful member of Christ's holy church as a representative of Christ in the world? If so, say, I do.
I do.
Okay, now it's all of your turns. Now, congregation, a family of friends, do you, as Christ's body, the church, reaffirm both your rejection of sin and your commitment to Christ? If so, say, we do. Will you nurture one another in Christian faith and life and include these persons now before you in your care? With God's
help,
we will proclaim the good news according to the example of Christ.
We will surround these persons with a community of love and
forgiveness, and they may grow in his service for others. We will pray for them, they may be true
disciples.
Let us join together in professing the Christian faith as contained in the scriptures of the Old and New Testament. Do you believe in God the Father?
Do you believe?